Well, a disturbing video of an AI deepfake of me has emerged online promoting a money scam.
Aussies won't have to work anymore. Elon Musk has made an amazing announcement about the new trading AI project, which is already available in Australia, spending just 5 minutes of your time to bypass the official trading platform yield test. Over 15,000 citizens have already received thousands of dollars in payouts and continue to earn with the market leader.
It is extraordinary. The Australian government is looking to ban high-risk uses of AI. And there are concerns, of course, these deepfakes will lead to mass misinformation. Strategy consultant and AI expert Adam Donnelly joins us now. Adam, thanks so much for your time. I mean, you look at that clip, you think, apart from the accent, obviously, it could be Karl. It's pretty frightening.
It is frightening. And look, these things are becoming increasingly more common, I think, with AI. The genie's well and truly out of the bottle. And we're seeing these scams being perpetrated every day of the week. They're a form of identity theft that really is quite concerning. In this instance, you know, they get an F because their technique was pretty poor. Yeah. They haven't matched the voice, but...
But the visuals?
The visuals are close enough.
The manner is... Well, they've just taken my video and changed the wording around the mouth, and that's enough to sell it to someone who may not be familiar with an Aussie accent, especially when you're talking about scams online.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Look, and they're just framing this up with people who have authority and they're targeting the vulnerable. And, you know, people are being duped by this. And they're using a technology that is, it's basically called a generative adversarial network that trains an image, and there's a computer neural network that's working using machine learning to try and create an image, and the other image is trying to detect it in the same time, and it just gets better and better and better to the point where you can't discern this from being the real deal. And I think that's the real worry here.
And I think the point Karl was trying to make, as well overseas, people might actually see this and believe it because they're not so familiar with the format, right? And are we seeing victims actually fall prey to these kind of things?
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, look, a CEO of a UK energy company was recently duped for $250,000. Wow. He got somebody call him up that was a member of the executive team, asked to transfer some money. We trust our ears, you know, we think, great, we know this person. He transferred the money. Mm. He found out it was a deep fake. So, yeah, there are lots of instances. Mm. It's being used in terms of actually extortion. Parents are being targeted. Yeah. Your kid's on the line.
Terrible.
Transfer the money. So we have to be alert to some of these scams.
It doesn't really worry me. I've been called a deep fake a few times. but for, like, even for cousins in Cairns who saw it, and they were, like, they were kind of aware that the accent was off, but they were still, like... Does the money scheme work?
Yeah.
Yeah, look, and that's the crazy thing. And, I mean, this is the same technology that, Hollywood are out and up in arms about at the moment, right? The AI and its application, it's got some amazing, you know, potential. Mm. And there are positive uses for this. It's being used for many, many good causes. But we've got to be on top of it. We've got to be regulating against it.
The good news for me, though, in a year's time, I'll be able to take another year off.
You will. No one will even notice.
Exactly like I did last time. Hey, thank you so much. Disturbing, but be aware out there.